What is going on, everybody? I am here with some more FarCry 4 last time. We did quite a bit of side missions. We did actually a lot, and we're almost done with all the side missions. So, I am here at the main menu, in the fact that that was something that I was trying to, I guess, happen for a very long time throughout the game, which is the propaganda center. That was the one we haven't done, which, I thought it happens randomly, but I checked online to see if I was right or wrong, and basically I was wrong. In order to activate the propaganda center, to activate those missions, you have to destroy, I believe you have to destroy a specific amount of propaganda posters, as you can see, or you have to destroy or tear down all 150. Propaganda posters. I still try to check online how many propaganda posters that you had to tear down. They didn't say if it was all of it or a specific sum, but I believe it, when I played it through the first time, you had to destroy a specific amount. I think there was, you had to destroy half or a quarter of the propaganda posters in order for the propaganda center side quest to activate. So, and I do want to show that, but I have to destroy a specific amount of propaganda posters. That I'll be doing off screen, so I won't take up too much time in the videos. And then I'll do that, and then I'll show the propaganda center side quests and stuff. And technically we're almost done. Oh, I still have to explain the racing and the survival. That I have to explain also. The collectibles, of course, like I said, I'm not gonna be collecting because it's just gonna take too much time. But like I said before, if we just buy the maps in the shops to find all the find all the collectibles, then he should have no problem. And of course, skills. So I'm gonna get more skills. We did all crafting. Well, I still need to do one more, but I don't know how does that activate. Oh, that's one thing I should have checked. God damn it. So now we're going to be doing a few more side quests. There's still 5 more side quests to go. And look, we're up in this one, so I don't have to travel and stuff. Yeah, we still have 5 more side quests to go. So we're going to be doing that we're going to be doing all 5 of these side quests in this episode. And then we're going to be doing the last 2 Shangri-La Thinker missions, and then we're gonna be doing the Golden Path mission, which of course it is gonna be the last one that we are going to tackle. So don't be worried about that. So all 3 of these things that we're gonna be doing, that all of them will be in a separate, they'll all be in separate videos, to not take up too much time.
Who is this?
Ajay, I'm hurt. You don't recognize my voice?
Should I?
The voice of Radio Freaky Rot? This is Robbie Ray Rana. You don't recognize that?
Right, Robbie Ray Rana.
Just call me Robbie Ray, man.
Okay, Robbie Ray, what's this about?
Look, we need a face-to-face. I'm sending you my coordinates. Come find me, man.
Ah, what perfect timing. I'm not gonna lie, that is very perfect timing. So I was right. You do have to destroy a specific amount of propaganda posters, which, of course, it's 5. Or maybe more. I don't know. It happens randomly. Usually, in my first shot, I think I destroyed more than 30 propaganda posters. And then propaganda sensor side quest did activate. So, where is he in the map? I don't see him anywhere. Where is he? I don't know where he is. Ah, he's right here. The propaganda center, yes. So we gotta go to him. But let's do that. So, we got one more thing to tackle down. So, we're gonna be doing that.
Are there any available fighters?
AJ here. I can help out.
Great. We're sending food to a starving village, but there's a danger it will spoil. So we need to move quickly.
No problem.
I'll send you the coordinates now, and be careful. The roads out there are treacherous.
Yeah, so we got one more side quest to do, which is the propaganda sensor. So we gotta hurry up, finish all these last two. So once again, there's one more thing stopping us way to get towards the last mission. To get towards the last mission of the game. So we're actually almost done, essentially. So that actually is pretty good. Oh, I had a grenade launcher in the last episode? Oh, I didn't know that. So I want to get through everything in this session. Great, now I have to back up, make space. Okay, so let's see, can this truck go now? Okay, good. Yeah, these guys were in the way. What the hell? So I do want to finish everything in this session. I do. I really do. I really want to finish everything in this session. So I hope we could finish the game, like I said, all in one session today. Not have any problems. Don't make any mistakes. So I'm trying to be as perfectionist and at the same time speedrun this. Because I have been working on... Oh, that was a nice shot there. I have been working on this game for a very long time. For almost a month now. I've been working on this game. Yeah, almost a month. Well, it's been 3 weeks, but... Yeah, for almost a month I've been working on FarCry 4. It took me a lot of time. Because, of course, open world games are not my thing. Because, as you've seen with other popular YouTubers and stuff, it takes a lot of time. But it's all worth it because I like to have fun with it. Oh, there's ammo here. Oh no, I'm trying to grab some ammo here, woman. Trying to. Damn it. What the? I'm trying not to shoot. What the? Okay, there we go. Yeah, I wasn't trying to shoot the car closely to the truck, or else it automatic explodes with the grenade launcher I have. Like I said, the grenade launcher does have splash damage, as you see what happened last time. Jesus Christ. The mistakes that I did doing these armored escort missions, that I've fired the grenade launcher so close to the truck that it explodes. Oh, good. Well, we're already here at the destination. Oh, ouch. Fell on my butt. Okay, nice. Oh, that's actually pretty cool. We're here. We got bonus rupees because... I don't know. What do we get bonus rupees for? I think bonus rupees keeping the truck not damaged a lot, I think. So we're here at the... other side quests, which is actually pretty good. Yeah, that's actually pretty good. So we're gonna be doing those. Can we go inside, I believe? I don't know. Can we? Can we go inside? Okay, the thing is inside here. No. Should have climbed down. Why is it not letting me up here? Duh. The blue door. Okay, let's do this one. Hunting control. Hello. Put the marker keys out of their misery and kill every single one in the area.
Hey, bro to bro, maybe you can help me out.
Yeah, maybe. What do you need?
So, I was kind of, maybe, sort of in prison for a while, and I made a big mess when I busted myself out.
What kind of mess?
Monkeys, dude! I strapped proximity mines to them to breach the walls, but they got out of their cages, and now they're running all over the bloody place. I'd be grateful if you'd put them out of their misery.
What is it with people and exploding monkeys? Fine. Just show me where to go.
But that sounds familiar. What? Putting bombs on monkeys sounds pretty familiar. I wonder which person actually did that. Oh yeah, and I did forget to explain that, like in Far Cry 3, and I believe in Far Cry 2, of course we have the introduction of collecting yellow leaves, red leaves, white leaves, and green leaves to create survival syringes, hunting syringes, of course, health syringes, all that types of stuff, burning syringes to prevent you from taking damage from fire, from the heavy gunners that have the flamethrowers. Those are the ones. That's one thing that I did forget to explain. Yeah, wipe out the monkeys. And yeah, that was the one thing I did forgot to explain throughout the whole game. I don't know why I keep forgetting them. Like I said, this is an open world game, and there's a lot to cover. So I explained as much as I know about this game as possible. So if I did forget, I forgot these are exploding monkeys. So if I did forget something, like, I apologize in advance. Because, like I said, this is an open world game, and there is so much to cover that I sometimes forget. Well, most of the times I forget everything. And also, you do have to be careful with these monkeys, of course, because they have the bombs, and if they come close to you, of course, they will explode and you will take damage. Oh, jeez. Okay. Move to the next area. Okay. I'm gonna move into the next area with my lucky MG42. Should have no problem taking these monkeys out. Where should I... Oh, yeah. The next area is over here. Yeah, it's a big area. Like I said, I'm gonna cover the rest of the other side stuff. Like the races and the hunting. I will be covering those. Well, I will be... Ouch. Well, I will be showing some examples. Of course, I'm not going to be doing the whole thing. You know, just to show. Because I'm not going to be doing that just to get 100% again. Because, you know, that's the way that I want to play. And of course, on Hunting Control, we succeeded. Yay! So that is the ones that I do want to... Well, that's the thing I did want to say. Was I will only be showing examples of what to do in order to get 100%. But I'm not going to be doing all of it because that would just waste a lot of time. To be honest, and I don't want to... Like I said in the past videos that... I don't want to drag a series for too long, especially if it's an open world game. I don't want to drag it out for too long. So, that's just me. That's just my opinion. Rhetorical question, right? Religion doesn't build roads. Actually, it does. But like I said, that is my own opinion, and that is how I'm gonna play it. So, why did it cancel out? Okay, good. Okay, so now we're gonna head towards the next. I think this one is the, I think you had to hunt a specific animal? So that's what we're gonna see. So we gotta go back inside here. And see what this man has for us. Use arrows of bolts to hunt yak, and the honor of grandfather's dying wish to taste sweet, kiwari oysters? Yeah, one last time.
I don't have enough.
I'll help. I can't deny a man his dying wish.
Oh, would you?
Grandfather will be so happy to sink his teeth into succulent, sweet balls of yak again.
Kirati oysters. Yeah, right. So what's the best way to bring these big boys down?
Bow and arrow. No question. We even have one you can use. It's in the shack over there.
And where do I find these yak balls?
I'll mark the location on your map. But bring back the whole yak, not just the oysters.
Hmm. Yeah, this would have been the perfect time to actually grab a curve bow, because that'd be great, because those deal a little bit more damage than a regular hunting bow. Let me see if I'm right, because I don't need those leaves anymore. Let me see if I'm right. Yeah, the recurve bow does quite a little bit more damage, so I'm just gonna be selecting that, and then we'll be heading towards the objective. Okay, so now we're here at the location, just to make sure that we have some bolts. So now we gotta hunt yak with arrows and bolts. I should have brought the other one. God damn it. The automatic one, with the one that has the bolts on it. That would have been a lot more better. God damn it, I should have thought of that. Well, as we saw, these yaks are not easy to kill with bows and arrows. And maybe bolts too, I'm not too sure. So we see one right here. And as you can see, these guys are not going to be easy to kill with the bows and arrows. Okay, we killed one. I see one right there. I've got to mark him. And these yaks will attack you, so you don't have to worry about them running away. So we gotta skin him. Yeah, two out of the four. Now, is there some down here? I don't think so. Where? Oh, there's one right there. And then there's, oh, two right there. Perfect. Usually when doing these missions, it takes a long time because you have to wait for them to spawn. Or they will spawn down there, which it's very frustrating because you have to climb down, then you have to climb back up again. And there's one right here too. Nice. Skin him. Okay, thank you. It took a long time. Okay, then we just need only one more. Of course, you could try getting these guys with headshots. And there we go, got all four. So now we just gotta deliver the meat to the next objective. And what is that? Oh. Wait, what am I doing? Take out the MG42! Okay, good. My god, that freaking leopard was coming at me. And isn't there something in here? I remember this spot being so specific. There isn't really nothing in here. Besides just a lot of stuff. Let's read this. Memo loot. I hate repeating myself, but it looks like I'll have to anyway. While I do frown upon looting, I understand that it is a necessary evil to keep moral up. Feel free to take whatever little knickknacks you see fit, but gold artifacts or high value items must be submitted to your highest ranking officer for further inspection. I pay you well. I expect you all to be professionals in return. Pagan men. Ah, so this is just a little storage place, but the only things down here is just a Just a loot crate. Just a little loot crate here. Nothing too special. But hey, I'll take what I can get when it comes to looting stuff. And there we go. Hunting supply success. So we did those last two. So now we have to do two more. Yay, so we finally made it. So it's the next side quest, the bomb defusing. The Royal Army has sent demolition team, of course. We gotta go to the...
What are these supplies?
Yeah, of course, there's no time to lose, even though he hasn't explained it to me. Great. So now we gotta fly up, so now we gotta go up to towards the objective. Defuse all bombs without being detected. Okay. So we gotta defuse this one, and that one of those two. So as you can see, this place looks very familiar. This is where we've destroyed the artillery. Yeah, as you can see, the broken artillery here. Now I do have the bow and arrow, so it will be... So I'll be a little bit more stealthy. I'm sorry, puppy. Sorry I had to do that. Here we go. I'll destroy that guy. Me being as late reaction. So then we gotta go towards the next one. So I could probably guess that these locations are going to be where that artillery is. Well, these two ones. One right there. And then the other one right over there at the bottom. As I can guess. And as you can see, this one is a little bit tricky because you have to defuse four. So if you accidentally get caught, you're gonna have a tough time actually running around and defusing them all. So I suggest being really stealthy as you can and do not get caught. And of course, using these buildings for cover is actually very perfect. So you won't get caught. Hoping there isn't anyone else sniping. Oh, I see there's one right there. I gotta get him. Right, first we gotta defuse that bomb. That was perfect. Hopefully there isn't anyone around here. There isn't no guards around here. Hopefully. Okay. Three out of the four bombs are down. Now we just gotta get towards one more. Hopefully, once again, there isn't any. Oh shit. God damn it. Okay, I'm just gonna run towards the... Run over here. Hurry up, okay, good. Escape the area. Okay, I'm gonna do that. Run away! Forget about these guys. There we go. Bomb defusing successful. So now we have one more side quest to do. This is going to be the last, well, not the last one, but yeah. Well, there's still one more to do, but I don't know how to activate that. The last real hunting thing. I don't know how to activate that, but so far, for now, this is going to be the last side quest that we are going to be doing for this game. So let's head towards it. Golden Path supplies. The Golden Path are in desperate need of supplies, of course.
AJ here. I read you loud and clear.
AJ. Yeah, AJ. Good.
Gopal, are you okay?
Yeah, you know the drill. Here are the coordinates for the drop sites. The Royal Army is on their way, so we need you to grab the ship before they do. Sorry, I have to go. Gopal out.
Hmm. Kopala's being weird as usual. But this time is much more weirder than we've been helping him catch these supplies. So now we gotta head towards the first drop-off point to get these supplies. God damn it. God damn it, Eagle. I'm trying to tear shit up and then you just come here in the way. So there's gonna be there's a tiger right there. Okay, destroy him. Now there is going to be some supplies around here if I'm not mistaken. It says here. It says somewhere around here. And that tiger just completely exploded. Wait, do we have to go down here in this cave?
Wait.
Kill those guys. But why isn't it? Is it not here? Why is it not here? Why is it not here? Is it underwater somehow? Okay, there's nothing here. Do I really have to go down under? Wait, I think I see it. Is it that? I think it is. Yes, we did. We got it. Well, I actually found it in my first try. I was this close to actually cut away.
First package recovered. Hello?
That's weird. They're not responding. How do I get out of here? Oh no, okay. Okay, now don't worry. I got out. Okay, so now we're gonna head towards the next drop off. Okay, so we're here at the next drop off point. Get out of my way. And of course, this location is familiar. This is when we did the last Reggie and Yogi mission. Where is this guy? Oh, we found him. And now this one should be up in the roof somewhere? Oh no, it's hanging. Yeah, it's hanging.
Go pal, if you can hear me, I've secured the second one.
Okay, so now we're gonna get towards the last one. And not let these freaking the Royal Army get to me. So trying to find a perfect place to land. And there we go. So now we gotta jump off around here. I think the last one's in this cave. Try not to. Last one.
The third package. I'm heading back to you now.
Okay, now we got 3 minutes to get up over there. We have no time to waste. So the last supply drop that we found was not that far from where this location is. Where we have to drop off the supplies to Gopal.
Hello? 20 Golden Path in the area. I found Gopal dead. His bunker's busted up.
Ajay, this is Rupa, the officer in charge of Golden Path operations in the area. Who is Gopal?
Golden Path. The enemy's securing supplies for you guys.
It wasn't us, Ajay. I have no Gopal under my command and no supply bunker in the area. Whoever he wasn't with us. Maybe you should have a look around.
Golden Path supplies. So let's have a look around. Regional and idols. Curiades worship a god named Banasho, who sang the song of creation and created all of the and created all the land. His enemies was Yaling, and he tore him apart. Banasho's daughter Kira is the most commonly seen icon in the statues and shrines. It's all very practical, nothing magical or mystical here. There's some great imagery and art that we can see surely put use for promotion purposes. For promotional purposes. I'll send over some examples. No, I didn't want to search his body when I read the note. Closing report. I'm not sure, but I think some of these are in order. So no, there's one here. Let me see this one. The big bad. This pagan ring guy is a self-promoted king to Kirat. And his flamboyant and larger than life in a way that doesn't always seem to jive with the Kirati people that I've met so far. There seems to be a lot of distant, and especially in the south. The story seems different in the north, but I can't tell what the fear of persecution and what is genuine. One thing for certain, the image he presents to the outside world is bullshit. Kirat is a mess, and it's mostly his fault. Well, duh! Have you been noticing that? We've been noticing that throughout the whole game. The closing report. I'm not sure that we should set things up here. While I enjoy the people, it seems that this is more than just a skirmish here and there. There is a full-blown civilian war, and people are getting killed. To repeat, we need to explore other locations and options and not come to Kirat for our own initiative. The rebels. The Golden Path don't like the pagan men much, and they sure did not mince words with me. They made up of a ragtag bunch of civilians, moms, dads, sisters, and brothers. And I have seen older fighters too. They are trained from generation to generation. They've learned guerrilla tactics with great stealth, natural predators. Their weapons and equipment are half stolen from the Royal Army and half smuggled in from Africa, as bizarre as that sounds. Sounds familiar. I haven't figured out that connection yet. Oh, we did. And this is the one that we haven't read? The industry. From what I've gathered, the major industries of Kira have been diverted by pagan, by the growth, refine, and export heroin to the US. This includes Kira Tea, the Russian brick company, Kira Earth and Oil Mining, and some smaller textile producers. It seems that Kira is now a very efficient self-contained civil to the Golden Triangle. As much as Pagan walks on the eccentric side of the street, this guy obviously very business savvy. So Pagan Man knows what he's doing when it comes to business. So basically, these are CIA operatives. So remember what Willis says, that we have been helping or killing CIA operatives? That's what we've been doing. To help with the civil war with Pagan Man, and then with the Golden Path. So that's what we have been doing. So now we have cleared every single one of the golden of the side quests so far. I still need to find out about the last Kira fashion week. I still need to find that out. But anyway, I've been going over 40 minutes now. So that is going to be enough for me for now. So next time on Far Cry 4, we're going to be doing the Propaganda Center side missions, because that's the one I did actually forget. Until next time.